Welcome back. The JDS podcast, episode numero tres. As always, I'm joined by my co-host, my brother. They call him the Double D. Daniel, how are you?
I'm good.
How was your day? How was last week?
Yeah, it was good. A lot of backlash for James being on the list last week. A lot of people were very happy that, you know, his actions were shown. Mm-hmm. And a bit of feedback, maybe a lot of people saying I held back a bit.
Oh, wow. Well,
but I thought it was fair.
Well, that's, yeah.
That's going to be in the list hall of fame.
He should learn his lesson from that.
Yeah, surely.
Yeah, well, if you're asking, my week was okay. yeah. Shout out again to all the viewers, followers. We had actually a couple of TikToks that popped off a little bit.
Yeah.
Good to see that. But yeah, let's, do you want to get, should we get into the agenda for today?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go. So, bang, 10 for 10.
Bang. Fan favorite.
We're going to dive into our other NBA teams. Don't look at my laptop. So last week we did the NBA teams out for our NBA players in our NRL team. We did the spine.
Yeah.
And today we'll be doing the our centers and wingers for the squad. We're going to end up with the whole squad, see whose is better in the end.
Yep.
And then we've got Would You Rather, a new segment. We've got a couple of Would You Rathers. Yep. Bit of a giggle. Bit of a laugh with that one. And then moving on to finish off, you just made the list. And let
Fan
me tell you,
favorite.
We've got some mentions. we've got some scoops. All right, so let's start off. Let's get straight into it. The 10 for 10.
Should we go? Let's just go.
Yeah.
Joel, you go first.
I'll take it away. All right, Daniel. We're exposing ourselves on TikTok. Like we're showing our lives. We're posting TikTok clips, right? And with that is going to come hate comments.
Yes.
And I wanted to talk about it. I didn't realize how, I don't know how I'd react to it, but when I saw this one, I just laughed. This is from an anonymous name. I won't say the name, but he commented on your Russell Westbrook take saying he's dog shit. He commented, "You can't say Russ is shit, bro. Put yourself in his shoes and try play. You won't average him." That's a little bit harsh.
I thought, you know, but we find the humor in it.
It is funny.
You know, it is funny, but
and especially when it's aimed at you. I mean, it's
well, different. Don't think you're getting off easy, Joel. Well, but it's aimed at you. There's one aimed at me there. Yes, and but can we just point out that if the person that's they may be listening, they actually deleted the comment
as well.
Soon as they get our reply, they remove it.
We get to see that coming in.
All right, number two.
Daniel, on the weekend, Friday night, went down to the local Clovelly Hotel. Great spot for some beers with some mates.
Yep.
And you know, after a couple of people venture out into the wilderness, and the wilderness is the pokies room.
On the slaps.
The pokey environment. Now, the boys that I was with will know why I'm playing this song.
She take my money.
So,
well, I'm in need. Oh, yeah. Yes, she's a trifling.
Troubles on in the pokies.
Friend indeed.
And just sees.
Oh, she's a gold digger.
Sees someone.
Well,
with
the town.
Green jackpot.
He did.
That digs on me.
Saying he was a bit of a gold digger because he wouldn't leave his side for the rest of the night.
Oh, okay.
Buying him drinks. Nick, the guy won 8,000.
Just a random guy. Yeah.
And you know, Nick pretty much didn't leave his side. It was like flies to shit the way he was going.
So he just was in it for the cash.
Yeah, just the pokey environment. How weird it can get. Very silly. Daniel, today, New South Wales and Queensland announced their teams. Two honourable mentions, Tom Gilbert and Jordan McLean, will make their debut for their respective states due to injuries. They're replacing players that were injured.
Yeah.
Now, they're both Cowboys players.
Yeah.
Now, Origin scene is flooded with Cowboys players. Do you think the Cowboys are pretenders or contenders?
I think, well, to be honest, at the start of the year, I thought they were going to come last. And I think a lot of people did. Obviously, they've overachieved by a mile.
I agree.
I think they're... I think it's Melbourne, Penrith, everybody else, really.
Yeah.
But the Cowboys are towards the top of everybody else. I'd say, who's fourth? Cronulla. I think the Cowboys have a better chance than them.
Look, I'm tipping Cowboys first round exit.
Really?
I don't think they win a game in the finals. I think they're definitely pretenders. Definitely pretenders. Okay. I wish they weren't, though, because it would be more interesting. But moving on, Daniel, Be Real, the new application.
Yeah.
It's a new application. Well, it's apparently it's been around for a while.
Has been.
I got on it on the early morning, on the early hours of Saturday morning.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but it's quite daunting and scary.
Is this because when you take the picture, it shows your face as well?
And the, yeah, and the
front. And the front.
And the front.
Yeah.
But yesterday I did one and I was actually in the bathroom.
Yeah.
And I had a 2-minute timer on the photo.
2 minutes.
It gives you, like, once you go on it after a while or something, it had like a 2-minute expiry.
Oh,
you had to take the photo within the 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And so I had to quickly rush what I was doing, which I didn't want to, but I had to quickly rush what I was doing, come downstairs, and I had to make a coffee. And
yeah,
I took a picture of my coffee.
Yeah.
It's kind of vibey, you know. I make coffees. Like,
yeah.
Kind of vibe. But yeah, I was just thinking, well, it's definitely a different app, and I don't mind it, but
I won't be getting on it, to be honest.
Fair enough. The fifth on the 10 for 10, Daniel, sickness. It's back again. You can probably hear it on my voice. I have a tiny cold symptom thing.
Yeah.
Right? So, like, last time I was complaining about how I sneeze once and mum offers me 6
coffees. This is the first episode.
The inaugural, right? It's happened again. Mum obviously heard me coughing during the night or something. Sneezing, whatever. And I felt okay in the morning. I walk downstairs, see the bench. There's a full bottle of cough mixture.
Yeah, I saw that as well.
A packet of Panadol.
Yes.
And I'm like, Mum, come on, Mumsy, really?
Well, she doesn't want you to get sick.
But, like, come on.
Well, do you think it's helped?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know, but it's just, yeah.
Three years ago, this wouldn't have happened.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, like, was there a COVID test? Ago. Was a COVID test offered?
No, there was no rapid
insurance. Okay, good.
Thank God.
Anyway, here we go, Joel. Now on to my 5. Number 1, Kevin Durant has requested a trade from the Brooklyn Nets.
Yes.
Where do we... Can you, like...
Yes!
Where do you think he's honestly going to go? Don't say the Lakers. Do not.
People are reporting Lakers are the only ones that can actually get both Kyrie.
Yeah, but they're going to have to give up their whole team, mate.
I'd love to... I think wherever KD goes, it has to be a big market for him. He can't go to, like, a...
Well,
like, I'd love for him to go back to Oklahoma.
His first... His preferred teams are Phoenix and Miami, the number one seed of each conference this year. That is poor from him. You know who I think a sleeper team is for Kevin Durant?
Who?
The Toronto Raptors.
I have heard that.
Woj has been throwing them around. They've got a lot of pieces that the Nets could like. Also, the Nets today I saw, obviously they're going to have to look to the future because both of them won out.
Yeah.
They traded their first round pick next year for Royce O'Neal from the Jazz.
Yeah.
What's that about?
The guy that was talking about it?
I think that's stupid. But I think Durant to the Raptors is a real possibility. Anyway, next. Latrell Mitchell rules himself out of State of Origin. Now, what I'm asking now, Joel, is do you think... I don't think he was going to get picked anyway.
I think he would have been picked.
And played.
Yeah, instead of Burton, I think.
Instead of Burton?
Yeah.
And Stephen Crichton would be in there?
Yes, Daniel.
Oh, I thought Burton would be definitely. I think Latrell's just said that because make himself look good. You know what I mean?
That's exactly like if they lose, everyone's going to be like, oh, they should have played Latrell. They should have played Latrell. That's the clout he wants. That's the clout he'll get because I can see Queensland winning game 3. I think it's going to be too hard in Suncorp. But look, focusing on South any other year because South are quite underwhelming at the moment.
Yeah.
Any other year, he might have chosen the Blues, but I think South, their struggles, they need the troll.
They need him.
They need him to warm up into that squad. But yeah, all the best to him.
Number 3, the New Zealand Warriors return home.
Wow.
Can I just...
Against your beloved.
Obviously, this was a huge game. Mount Smart is sold out. You know, it's the first time. Did you see how they actually entered the stadium? It was like they were going into war against the poor Tigers.
Chills. Literal chills.
Also, my point here, though, is what I want to ask you is, I definitely think the NRL have strategically made New Zealand versus the Tigers in that game so they would win. Like, imagine they go, the first game back at Mount Smart, they play Penrith and lose 30-6.
That's true, I guess.
I think that there's definitely a bit of planning there from the NRL to make sure that the Warriors win that game.
Any other year, though, the Tigers-Warriors game should be competitive.
Yeah, but the occasion, like, I was watching the game. It was over before it even started. The Warriors players are crying in the dressing room. It was over. And they come out to the war thing.
I agree.
It was unbelievable.
The Tigers were destined for failure.
Anyway, Joel, had a bit of a focus on sport. in the last three. Let's shift over to the entertainment side. Stranger Things. Obviously, I don't watch Stranger Things. You don't watch Stranger Things.
I'm not a geek.
A lot of people watch Stranger Things. And I saw a thing. Netflix spends upward of $30 million an episode.
On Stranger Things,
right? So, how much money do you think each episode makes if they're spending $30 million on each one? Surely, they've got to be at least tripling that number.
I think at least quadruple. Otherwise, it's...
But don't you think that's a ridiculous amount? Like, movies have less budget than that. And well, this 30 million an episode, so there's 10 episodes a season. That's 300 exactly. million at least.
Well, when you're saying they're spending 30 million, that's the first thing you think of. What are other things?
Yeah, and what are the profits like? Because, and obviously, I'm pretty sure the next season's the last season, I've heard, Stranger Things.
I saw something, the network was actually failing because so many people were watching it, so.
Oh, Netflix. Yeah, okay. Bouncy off that, Joel. I want you to give me your top three television shows of all time.
Daniel, you know I don't watch TV.
Give me your top three. Top 30 three. From three.
Oh, fuck. You put me on the spot here. I'll go one. Number one.
Yeah.
Joe Exotic's documentary.
Tiger King.
That's got to be number one. You give me your three first. Let me.
Yeah, number three. I'll go MasterChef Australia. I'm kidding. Imagine, I'm kidding. No, number three, I'll say, fuck, it's tough,
I don't watch TV.
Just give me number one. Let's go number one.
Joe Exotic.
I'll say The Office.
Oh, okay.
Steve Carell, Dwight Schrute, Jim Halpert.
Classic.
Kevin Malone, honorable mention.
Underrated.
Underrated. Yeah, so what's your number one is Tiger King. Your number one TV show of all time. That's poor.
I'm a loser. That's poor.
Maybe you should have said MasterChef Australia. Anyway, that's the 10 for 10. A bit of controversy there.
Keep you updated with what's going on the world.
And it's just bang, bang, bang.
Bang, anyway, Daniel.
What's next?
Speaking about banging, let's move on to banging out our NBA NRL hybrid. Hit me with the bells.
Back to the draft.
So let's remind the viewers, if you didn't watch the second episode where we went through our 1, 6, 7, and 9, go back to it right now, but let's refresh them. So my fullback is Anthony Edwards. My 5'8 is Giannis Antetokounmpo. My halfback is Kawhi Leonard. And my hooker, controversially, I have been called a clown,
is LeBron James. I think your whole team was a bit controversial.
Moving on. Daniel?
Okay, to recap, my fullback was also Anthony Edwards. At the number 6, I had Luka Doncic. Halfback Steph Curry and hooker Chris Paul. Can we talk about the comment that was made?
You go.
The first TikTok. This was also deleted. You know, people, they talk shit and then they get the response and then
wrong.
They delete.
They're wrong.
Someone commented, what did they say? How could LeBron play at hooker or something?
Well, that was one of them. Another one. I said generic.
Chris Paul was a generic pick, and then you proceeded to say LeBron James was your pick. And someone commented, bro said Chris Paul was generic, and then said LeBron with the cloud emoji, which we replied to.
Hurts it.
And then they delete it. Anyway,
moving on. So
now we've got two wingers, two centers.
Yep, we're going to finish off the back line. Do you want to go? We'll go winger for winger.
Okay, yeah.
So on my. I've gone.
Joel, can I just. I think you're going to be looking for a bit of redemption here.
I think I've got it.
Okay, go on.
So. Just don't look at my screen, please. My right wing, lining up on the right wing for me, is going to be Ja Morant.
Ja Morant, yes. Okay, I like that.
Okay. Hops is like, I wanted height, but I couldn't really find anyone. He's got the hops. He's explosive at the back end. I'm looking at him as he's going to be my Brian Toto of the squad.
Brian Toto, yep.
Not the same muscular capacity, but quick, explosive footwork. Ja Morant will be on the right wing for me.
Okay, moving on to my right wing. We've got the man out of Sacramento, De'Aaron Fox, on the right wing. Okay. You know, I think De'Aaron Fox, Josh Adakar. The speed there is just insane. And I think, if he gets it, if he has room to move, he will be a try-scoring machine.
Well, Daniel, funny you say that because our De'Aaron Foxes will be lining up against each other. I've got him on the left. I've got him on the left wing.
Again.
He's the quickest player in the NBA, I think.
Yeah.
He is the alike version of Josh Adakar, but Melbourne Storm Josh Adakar, not Canterbury Bankstown Bulldogs Josh Adakar.
Well,
come on.
On the left wing for me, sorry, I noticed you said
Ja Morant, who is someone that I considered, and then you said, I don't think he's got the same muscular, not the same. He's a bit skinny. Well, that's why on the left wing, I've gone for Zach LaVine. He could jump, and how much more built is he than Ja?
Forgot about him.
Yeah, well, I he could get up high for the crossfield kicks that Luka and Steph are going to be giving him, yeah. Right? And
I don't know how I'm going to combat that.
Yeah, he's just, I mean, the hops are there, the muscles there. He's just got a good build, I think.
All right, into the centers. Right center, pairing up with Ja Morant, my right edge. Wow.
Yep.
Zion Williamson. I've gone right center.
Are you serious?
When he got drafted.
It's like a bit of a Talakai.
That's exactly what I've got written down. When they drafted him into the NBA, Daniel, they said if a player took a charge on Zion Williamson, it's like getting hit by a four-wheeler truck. Actually, the same power. Yeah, I've gone.
You might have to fact check that one, Joel. Same power as a truck.
Four-wheeler. Look it up.
Like a ute.
Talakai is going to be my Talakai player. Being like a strong center and he's got great skill on the ball.
Okay. On my right center position,
yep.
I don't think this play would even have come into your mind.
This could be a fault in your.
I don't know. Well, I don't think it's a fault at all. The Olympic gold medalist, Keldon Johnson, in the right center.
That's pathetic, Daniel.
The strength of the man. Have you seen. Joel! Keldon Johnson is one of the most muscular small forwards in the league, right? He's going to be like my... Who's he going to be like? He's going to be my Adam Dewey.
That's pathetic.
He's just going to be a beast. And all he has to do is... Keldon's going to break the line. He looks to his right. There's De'Aaron, right? De'Aaron's through. De'Aaron's gone.
Keldon's breaking any lines.
Okay, who's on your left?
So, Daniel, you actually reminded me of someone... I might change my...
Whoa, there's going to be a swap, is there? Who have you got now? Tell us who you're changing from.
You know, no, I'm going to stick solid. I'm going to go my left center, Jason Tatum.
Yep, okay.
Left center, like Jason Tatum. Footwork tall, that Mamba work ethic. I'm relating my Jason Tatum at center to a prime Will Chambers.
Will Chambers?
Prime Will Chambers.
Just, is it because of the same haircut?
You could say that. That talk, that chatter, you know, getting under people's skin. I think Tatum will be a great addition to my squad. Tall, okay defensively, but attacking wise.
Okay, so I'm going to match your Jason Tatum selection with the man that actually locked him down in the NBA Finals, Andrew Wiggins, in my centers.
Oh my God, are you serious?
Andrew Wiggins. Joel, imagine Andrew Wiggins is my Joey Manu, my... What's wrong?
Joey Manu to Andrew Wiggins.
Andrew Wiggins. Joel, imagine Lucas put up a crossfield kick on last tackle. Andrew Wiggins goes up for it, bats it down to Zach LaVine.
You've really hurt yourself.
Try time.
You've really hurt yourself.
I don't think I've hurt myself at all.
You really have.
But I want you to tell me how Giannis is going to put up. Like last week you said Giannis was just going to run the ball.
Yep.
So who's kicking to this left and right edge?
Kawhi Leonard. LeBron out of hook.
Yeah, okay. LeBron out of hook.
Not even kicking. We'll just pass.
No, I think you could have. I think your spine last week does not correlate with these edges at all.
We'll have a look, Daniel. We'll see what the comments say. Hey?
Okay, yeah, well.
Well, that's our teams.
That's the draft.
That was our. So next week we'll do the forward pack.
Yeah.
Finish off the forward pack and then.
Looking forward to your selections again.
Well, based on this week, yours, you didn't make.
Yeah, well, obviously you're going to be a bit biased, mate.
All right, Daniel, would you rather... It's time for a giggle. It's time for a laugh. Would you rather, okay?
Yeah.
So we're doing this in the sense that we wanted to... we want the podcast to be applicable to a lot more, a wide range, a target audience. So adding a bit of comedy, let's see how this goes, okay, Daniel?
Yeah.
My first one. Would you rather always have BO and not know it, or always smell BO on everyone else?
I would rather... One of mine that I've written is extremely similar.
Really?
But I'll still say it.
Okay.
It is worse.
Answer mine.
Okay. I would say I would rather always smell BO on everyone. Does that mean that... Yeah.
Yeah, you don't stink.
I don't want to stink. I'm going to be selfish there.
Look, it's definitely a daunting concept. But yeah, I think I'd have to agree. I'd rather smell BO on everyone else because... You know, you can prevent that.
Yeah. Sort of.
But knowing that you stink would be extremely just yuck.
And like, I feel like you get told as well.
Okay, Daniel, my second one.
Yeah.
Would you rather let a crusty old man drink milk out of your belly button every day for a year, or drink milk out of a crusty old man's belly button every day for a month?
So what the, where have you found this? Out of a belly every day for a year, or...
Or you...
Every, oh, so 365 times.
Yep. That's out of your belly button, or drink it for a month out of his. I'm going
to... I want to hear yours.
I'm going to... There's no right answer here.
There isn't.
It's actually quite disgusting. But it's
just, you just have to make the sacrifice.
I'm actually regretting putting this one in, actually. I'm going to go reluctantly lick out of his belly button.
Oh, I'm going to go the other way.
Really?
Because I feel like, yeah, Joel.
I'm just going to get over and done with it. After a month, that's it. I'll never see him again. You're going to see him for a whole year.
Mm, true. That is a tough one. Strange one at that as well. Yeah, I might go. Excuse me. I might go. No, I'm going to stick to it. I don't know. I don't know. Make it's weird decision. Either way. We like I can just it's, there's no answer here.
Make a decision right now.
I'm gonna say I'm gonna let him drink out of my belly button for a year.
That's disgusting, Daniel. What are yours?
But there is no taste. Okay, now my first one, because I knew you'd go the comedic route. I want to have one that we can have a bit of discussion about.
Okay.
Would you rather, if you, say you're in the NBA, would you rather ride the bench for a year and you win a ring? You win one ring in your career, you ride the bench for 10 years.
Yep.
Or you never ring a ring, but in your 10-year career, you're an all-star every year.
And I'm on the bench for 1 year and I win a ring?
But you're on the, no, you're on the bench for 10 years and you win a ring in the 10th year. Like you have a 10-year career and in the 10th one, 10th year you win a ring, that's your career. Or
the other one. I'm going to do the other one.
You'd be an all-star.
For 10 years.
And you'd never win a ring. Yep. Never, no finals, no nothing.
Well, think about the money I'm making being an
all-star. No, it's the same, same. No, it's just reputation here. Impossible. We're talking about reputation.
That's impossible.
It's a hypothetical. No, that's We're just talking about reputation. Would you rather be, you know, a Patrick McCaw or a Charles Barkley?
Charles Barkley.
Yeah, but...
yes. You just literally ring. Just proved my answer.
Well, I'm going to say, yeah, the 10 All-Star thing.
Oh, so yeah, there you go. You're agreeing with me.
Yeah. But I thought you would go the other way because you. I feel like you just want the ring.
I'm a money-hungry man.
Okay. This is the one that's kind of similar.
Oh, the BO one?
Yeah, but it's just personal to you, right? Would you rather only smell like shit or you just constantly smell shit, like in your nose? It's tough. I feel like, it's the sort of the same premises, but there is a big difference here because your one, you're smelling BO on everyone else, right? So if you're not with anyone, you're fine. But this one, you're just constantly smelling shit.
I think I'd constantly smell shit. Because if you smell like shit, wouldn't you smell it?
No. You think you're too hard about him.
This is terrible.
This is, I personally would constantly smell shit.
Yuck.
But yuck. Because well, I,
wait, hold on. Who's shit?
No. Why would that make a difference, mate?
Ah, oh, fuck. This is different.
It is tough.
I'm gonna smell like shit.
Smell like shit? You're gonna smell like shit for your whole life.
What was the other one?
Or constantly smell shit.
No, constantly smell shit.
I'm constantly smelling shit as well because I feel like after amount of time. When you might get a bit used to it. You know, it might just seem a bit...
Well, that's... Yeah, well, I mean, we could adapt as a human. Evolve.
You're not going to evolve if you're the... It only applies to you.
Theory of evolution. Charles Darwin. Shout out my investigating science boys. Shout out. And my teacher.
Oh, God. Oh.
Disgusting, isn't it?
Okay. Is that it? Is that would you rather?
Yeah, that's would you rather.
So... For next week, I think we're going to get a couple submissions. For would you rather? Yeah, we'll get a couple of
submissions.
We'll get a couple of ideas from the audience.
Daniel, now moving on to the best segment on this podcast.
You just made the list!
It's all right. Anyway, before we get in, Joel.
Yeah.
I've been getting asked a lot of questions about the list. Because, you know, I don't know if you found, but obviously we've done like friends and family, first two episodes. Mm. A lot of my friends are like, they act a bit cautious around me.
Obviously, they don't want to make the list.
They don't want to make the, yeah, but it's, and then they try to like, if someone does something, they're like, Daniel, put him on the list for that.
Mm.
I need to make it clear now. Oh, like, you don't tell me who's on the list, right? That's a decision we make, yeah?
Before the podcast.
I've also been asked, can you make the list more than once? And yes. We've actually had a bit of a mention.
Yes.
For one of the inaugural members, Sam Kennedy.
That's correct. Look, it would be historic if someone made this.
Twice.
I think it's too early for it.
But
we have a source. We have a source that has mentioned multiple violations.
From Samuel.
I'm saying he could make the list 5 times from what I've heard.
Well, I know a bit of backstory behind it.
Well, let's not go into it because that's not what we're focusing on.
But Sam is just a bit, he could be on it every week.
Literally. Anyway, moving on. I'm going to start off. Yeah, I was actually going to mention that. But I've actually, before I get into my member of the list, I'm going to have another special mention to that I think has to be notified. I'm going to go. So we were at Bo Ayoub.
Yeah.
Friend of mine, right? He.
So this isn't your pick?
No, it's not my pick, but I just wanted to mention it. Because this is actually quite funny. He came up, we're at the Cleverly Hotel on Friday. He said, Joel, I'm going to make the list tonight.
Yeah.
I'm going to make the list.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, let's go. I'm excited to see what he could fuck up, like what he might do. Yeah. Right? So, but anyway, we actually went to the place we went to for the evening after the Clavelli Hotel. He actually didn't get let in.
Oh, okay.
Because he was wearing G'd Up. You know the G'd Up brand?
Oh, it had the big letters?
Yes, yeah. The jumper. He actually wears it a lot. But yeah, he did. So like that wouldn't make the list, but it was just funny how he said, I'm going to make the list.
Yeah, and then kind of jigs himself there.
But moving on.
Can we just point out the little comment from the start of the podcast about sickness? Are you okay?
Moving on.
Jesus.
Jared Sutton.
You just made the list.
Jared, this is a good one.
Jared Sutton, the NRL referee. He's an NRL referee. He officiated the Sydney Roosters Penrith Panthers clash at Bluebet Stadium on Friday night. And let me tell you, it's one of the worst performances I've ever seen.
The Roosters are essentially robbed.
It's like, and it kills me to say it. The Roosters deserve to win. I'm saying that, Jared. You've got me saying that. He ruined the flow of the game and some calls were blatantly wrong. And you know you stuffed up when Trent Robertson, quite a quiet, confidential guy.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Roosters head coach.
Absolutely sprays you in the press conference. And this officiating performance, it made me think of other officiating performances I've seen.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go local as well.
Local?
Like, so we were actually, as you may know,
I was a junior rugby league referee
with some of our mates. And I wanted just to mention, on the back of Jared Sutton's poor performance, Sam Nealon's poor referee performance.
Yeah. I know where this is going.
Think of it. So Sam Nealon was actually referee at Quidditch Oval, under sevens game, mini league. That's what they call it. He's jogging back to get the 5 metres, defensive line set, trips over, breaks his arm in 2 places. As a referee.
Surgery required.
So he is a referee that is getting carried off the field. The game's had to be stopped and he's on the green whistle on the side.
Well, the under sevens are ready to go.
So yeah, but Jared Sutton, look, and we've actually had an external source that someone high up has said that he is a shit referee as well. So
not going to name names there.
Not going to name names, but we are all on the same page. And especially when you're given a game like that, a top 8 clash like that, it's a good game. It's a Friday night prime game. And you're putting up a performance like that. Look, we respect the referees, but sometimes they have to be called down upon.
Yeah.
So Jared Sutton, that is why you
just made the list!
Now, I just want to add a little note onto that Jared Sutton thing. When you talked about past performances.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks ago, we organized an Oztag game because we play Oztag in summer.
Is this to do with your list?
I just want to tell a funny story.
Okay.
And I was appointed referee.
Correct.
Right? This is another thing, like Sam Kennedy, like, oh, he's gonna be a legend of the list.
Okay.
I had to send Sam Kennedy off for 10 minutes in Oztag. Is that just unbelievable? 10 minutes in the bin in Oztag. Professional foul.
I'm not even going to ask.
We made him miss one set.
I'm not going to even ask what it was.
It was just, yeah. Anyway, that just made me think of it. Anyway, on to mine. Again, I'm staying within the friend group.
You could lose a lot of friends here, Daniel.
No, but everyone's going to end up on it eventually. And I think last week it was given that it was James. Yeah. It's going to be hard to follow up from that. But this week, Alex Kaznadi.
You just made the list.
Okay. We're continuing on. We're continuing on from...
Talk to me.
Now, in our group, you know, a lot of us, we have sports bet, yes? Alex...
Dangerous.
Alex didn't really have it until we went to the races. He made an account and started, right?
Fatal.
And he's got a little bit of an addiction there.
Fatal.
A little bit of an addiction.
As if you'd start betting at the races. That's
Anyway, he's got a bit of an addiction. Ed, the other night we went out and we went to Jacob's house before. Mm-hmm. And Alex was there, and he put a bet on, what was the game? The Bulldog Sharks game.
Tough game,
right? I don't know if he won, but then he put one on the next game, which was Cowboys Broncos. And here is why Alex is just here's why he's on the list. He's probably the worst bettor I've ever met. One of the worst. I'm not going to name names, but I want you to tell me, Joel.
Yourself.
I want you. I make no, that's enough. I want you to tell me when what state. Do you think the North Queensland Cowboys versus Brisbane Broncos game would be played at?
Queensland.
General knowledge. Exactly. Correct. On the money. Alex does his bet. I think he did Oats to score, Cowboys to win, Cowboys first to 10, and a Cowboys play to score.
That's okay. Yeah.
Okay. Did that. That's okay. And then he was like, oh, he didn't win, right? But he goes... I was going to do, like, this is his thinking. He goes, I was going to do over 38.5 points, which it was.
Yeah, it's like 60 right? something.
He was like, I should have done that. But then I thought, because the Bulldogs and Sharks game was raining, like the weather would stuff them up. The Bulldogs and Sharks game was in Sydney.
Yeah.
So he thought the Cowboys and Broncos game was in Sydney, and that's why he didn't do it. Part two. Ask me about the Souths game. Who should bet? I said, Trell Mitz back. I think Souths will dominate Parramatta.
That's it.
Joel Mitz returning.
That's it.
Going to mention someone here. Nick Shalhoub disagreed.
Yeah.
Right? Said the Eels. Alex goes for the Eels. Souths win 30 to...
Doesn't matter.
Whatever. At half... It was right to be half time. It was 12-6, right about to be half time. And we were watching it on my phone, and I turned it off. And then Alex was like, let's watch the last minute. Soon as we turn it on, Mitchell Moses tries to tap it onto the wing. Alex Johnson intercepts 18-6 at halftime. The final score was 30-12 or something.
Classic.
So, Alex, because of your sports bet blunders, that is why...
You just made the list!
You just made the list.
Well, well, well. Kills me to say it, Daniel, but that's the end of another episode.
Episode 3 in the books.
Episode 3 is done. Keep liking, keep sharing, keep subscribing.
Get ready for, you guys are going to be in next week with the Would You Rathers. Get your Would You Rathers ready.
Get your Would You Rathers ready. I can't wait to hear them.
Yeah, I feel like there'll be some funny ones.
The voice messages get me every time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's episode 3 in the books. What are you liking, commenting, subscribing?
Like, comment, share, subscribe. Shout out to our international viewers. Shout out to our international viewers.
A couple internationals, yeah.
America, everywhere. We're going global.
JDS global. Worldwide. Anyway, should we hit him with a song?
See you next Tuesday, lovelies. Peace, love, and happiness.